Tell the kids in the morning.
Were you the kids and stuff?
Yeah, it's awesome. We're the kids.
I'm live now, I'm not trying to bet, I just wanted to go. I turned this on to make sure it worked. Yeah, so, we'll see. You know how that goes. Thanks for the peanut butter egg. I don't need it, but thank you. Was it?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I added Bob and Sherry to this, but maybe I didn't.
Good afternoon, parents, grandparents, students, friends, and sports fans, and welcome to Doc Edwards Memorial Field at the Baltic Area High School in the heart of Wingate, Pennsylvania. Today, the PIAA defending 2A state champion Baltic Area Eagles will play host to Mount Union High School in a varsity baseball matchup. Before we announce today's starting lineups, we ask that you please rise if you are able. Direct your attention to the colors flying proudly above the center field fence, as we will honor America with the playing of our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting through the night, that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the
today's starting lineups. First for the visiting team, the Mount Union Area Trojans.
I mean, I can watch it on. I can watch it on my phone.
Starting at shortstop, number 9, Jamon Ram.
Let's try to.
At second base will be number 5, Kanan Atherton. Doing the catching today, number 33, Blaine Hunsinger. In center field, number 7, Landon Kreismer. At third base, number 12, Dylan Schauber. At first base, number 17, Levi Hunsinger. Left field designated hitter is number 10, Bryce Danish. Number 3, playing right field, Wyatt Kreismer. And number 28, doing the pitching today, is Cody McLean. The head coach is Tim Hicks. Assistant coaches, Ryan McGonigal, George Goodling, Ron Blair, and Jeff Brown. Now for your Baltic Area Eagle. Starting at shortstop, leading off will be number 2, Cale Burns. Left field, number 26, Gavin Burns. At second base, number 9, Peyton Yoder. Third baseman today, number 22, Carson Nagel. Your designated hitter, number 12, Braden Dubs. Doing the pitching is number 13, Weston McLean. Behind the plate, number 24, Caden Burns. At first base, number 40, Wyatt Speckman. Connor Perry, number 1, is in right field today. And your center fielder, number 42, Cameron Watkins. The Eagles, of course, are coached by Mr. Jim Gardner. Assistant coaches, Command Sergeant Major retired John Jones, Ryan McNamara, Luke Gardner, Justin Taylor, and Zach Roach. Your umpires today, Mr. Tom Berger on the base paths, and behind the plate, Mr. Mike Kresovich. Enjoy the game.
All right, Joe's done with his introduction, so we're going to get ready for the first pitch. A little timeout here. Caden Burns getting something checked with the old high-tech. What do they call that? Pitch calm. Yeah. Who all can hear that? Just the pitcher?
No, just the catcher.
Oh, just the catcher. Okay. In the majors, do they all hear it? Because I've seen... Can they all hear it?
I didn't miss anybody. I didn't have that crash.
Okay. I just wondered. All right, so... Trying to get this set up. First pitch is a ball. Trying to keep an eye on two events here at the same time. What was that second pitch?
Ball.
Two balls, okay. So Weston McLean is your pitcher today for the Eagles. He's down behind two balls, one strike on the leadoff hitter for Mount Union.
Jamon Rank.
Was it Jamon Rank? Two strikes. Get down. What number is he, Joe?
He's number 9.
He's batting .588 on the year. He's a freshman. Pop fly out of play.
Very young.
Yeah, so he's had 17 at bats. He has 10 hits, so he's 10 for 17. Two RBIs, two doubles.
And they have two veteran pitchers.
Two top pitchers are out with arm injuries. There's another pop fly. First baseman's over. Wyatt Spackman, first base tonight. So defensively, the Eagles have
second baseman number 5.
Left field, Gavin Burns. Center field, Cam Watkins. Right field, Connor Perry. Third base is Carson Nagel. Shortstop, Cale Burns. Second base, Tate Yoder. First base, Wyatt Spackman. Catching is Caden Burns. Pitching is Weston McLean. What number is this guy?
Number 5.
Sorry, I'll pay attention. Number 5 is now batting for Mount Union. Atherton, senior. He's batting .357 on the season. He's 5 for 14. He has 6 RBIs. First pitch is a strike. Strike 2.
They lost their opening game and then won the next four.
Yeah, they lost their opening game to McConnellsburg. Why can't I see the softball game?
Just helping you out here.
Well, that's fine because we're trying to do a lot of things. Pop fly out of play.
You and I work well together. You're the only one that spells my name correctly.
Oh, here, now he's sucking up.
Still up.
Did you get a hold of those people? You said you were going to email them.
I did, yes. I think I actually have a response. So ball 1, 1 ball, 2 strikes on the second baseman. What's his first name? Cam Atherton.
Kanan.
Ball 2. 2-2. Let's see. The softball, I can't even see. I don't want to score it.
Okay.
So count's now 4. Trying to do two things at once, everybody. Because softball's playing Bellwood Annis down on the varsity softball field. Ground ball in between short and third for a base hit. Mount Union has their first runner on of the day.
The catcher, number 33, Blaine Hunsinger.
So Blaine Hunsinger now comes to the plate for Mount Union. He's a senior. He's batting .357 on the season. He's 5-4-14. So Mount Union has a runner on first, one out. Pitches a ball.
Softball maybe not started yet. No, they haven't started.
Hey, Wes. Hey, Wes.
Yeah, they have. Well, so that's ball two. I have to keep an eye on that as best I can, since we have a dad here that has kids playing in both games. Ryan Burns doing the scoreboard, doing the game changer. Two balls, one strike. There's another flare out to right field. That should have been caught. I don't know why it wasn't. Of course, I forgot to move the camera. So that was a little flare out to right field in front of right fielder Connor Perry. Yeah, so Mount Union has two straight hits now. I'll get myself together here, everybody. I apologize. So courtesy runnings, number 21, Collins.
Number 7, Landon Chrysler.
21, Collins, freshman. They don't have a JV program.
How do you pronounce his name?
One more.
I have no idea. The last name's Collins. Inside, called strike. One strike, one out. Runners on first and second. Two straight hits by the Trojans. Eagles and Trojans battled three times last year. Once in the regular season, once in the district championship, and one in the PIAA championship. One ball, one strike.
Trying to run for Hunsinger is number 21. That's Collins. Collins.
Mount Union with a little bit of life here in the first inning.
On top, baby, on top.
Runner on second, has a normal lead, gets another step off. McClain comes to the plate. Swing and a miss. One ball, two strikes. So now you're doing game changer and a regular ball.
You now?
Just because I have a couple times that it gets backed up and I got it back.
I understand. I'm not making fun of you. I miss doing that. I like doing the announcing, but I love keeping score. Swing and a miss, strike three. So two outs now. Mount Union still has runners on first and second. Next batter's coming up. Joe's going to announce him.
Number 12, Dylan Shaver.
Dylan Shaver's a junior. He's batting 267 on the year. He's 4-for-15. Softball's already in the bottom of the first.
No score. All zeros on the board.
That's a shot to left field, but it looks like a can of corn for Gavin Burns. Hopefully I got that in the screen. Feel free to let me know, folks, at the Clarence Legion, the Hoffman
family, two runners left on base.
Anybody else that's
watching. We are scoreless as we move to the bottom of the first inning.
So we're going to go into the bottom of the first inning. The Eagles coming up to bat. I click on the baseball and it comes up like how I watch it when you normally do it. I click on the softball. Attention here, Joe's probably going to give you the starting lineups for us, our starting batting lineup. I can almost guess this one. Let me close my eyes. Leading off will be shortstop Cale Burns. Batting second will be left fielder Gavin Burns. Batting third, second baseman Tate Yoder. Batting fourth, third baseman Carson Nagel, right?
You got it.
Batting fifth, is it Wyatt Spackman? Oh, Brayton, DH, and I'm sorry. I know he has an appointment with God tonight. Tonight's confirmation night. I actually told him, since he gave up 10 hits yesterday at Belladonna, that the guy on the other side only takes people to give up 10 hits in a varsity baseball game pitching. God only takes people to give up single digits.
After that.
But that's just a joke, everybody.
pitcher. But
yeah, so Weston McLean is not batting. And then so then Spackman's batting sixth. Okay, Burns is batting sixth and catching. So batting seventh is Wyatt Spackman. Batting eighth is right fielder Connor Perry. And batting ninth, and it hurts to say this, and batting like 758 on the season is Cam Watkins. I want to know if they're setting the tee up for him, because now I'm just teasing. I told his girlfriend I'd get a good cheap shot in.
Shortstop, number two, Cale Burns.
All right, so Cale Burns is leading off for the Eagles here, and let me see if I can pull up the Eagles stats that I downloaded.
Thank you.
So Burnsy is batting 429. Of course, his dad does the scoring. That's all I'm going to say. No, Jim checks it every night. As a matter of fact, he said he added some hits last night, so maybe you were being too hard on some field. No, he's batting 6 for 14 on the season, batting 429. He has a one ball, one strike count on him. There's a ball in play right at the left fielder who's going to play it off of his glove. I hate to say it, even though he's my boy, I'd say that's an error. Are you serious?
Because that ball is rising over his head.
Oh, my gosh. You're a softy, anyway. No, I just like her.
So what is it?
I just want it on the record that I object that that's a hit.
Left fielder, number 26, Kevin Burns.
He calls me Pappy. So he doesn't get any gifts from me.
All
right, so now we have Gavin Burns. Gavin had a big day yesterday. I don't think I put the story out on Facebook today. I just remembered that. What's his number 26? He's batting 667 on the season. The pitch was high. No, I'm just, hey, they're the tough ones. Yeah, they're tough ones. But I just went on the record. It wasn't his dad. It was Joe. There's a ground ball to right field. So is Burns going to score? He does score on the single. They throw it away. Gavin had gone back to first. Yeah, so Gavin Burns stays at first base, but he gets a RBI single. So the Eagles are cooking with gas already in the first inning. And I think I caught all that action.
Number nine, Peyton Yoder.
I say we end this puppy right now because it only can go downhill from here.
Hit it hard, Taylor. Hit it hard, baby.
So this is Peyton Yoder. He had a tough day at the plate. He had a couple RBIs. He's batting 188 in the season.
He had a little funky pitching yesterday. That can throw you off.
Oh, yeah, and I'm not being critical of him. He's just not in the groove right now. There's a little pop fly out over shortstop. He goes back and catches it for the first out. So Tatum's making contact. He's just not getting the ball to drop in yet. It's still early. What is this, our fourth
number
game?
Number 22,
yeah.
Carson Nagel.
They're going to play a crap ton of baseball in the next 2 weeks, hopefully.
The
sun just came out. That yellow thing in the sky, that's called the sun, everybody.
Blue sky. That's right.
So Carson Nagel's now batting. What number's he wearing? 22. He's batting 312 on the season. He takes a called strike. Eagles lead 1-0 here in the bottom of the first. One out. Gavin Burns singles in Cousin Cale, who was given a gift single by Joe Pillett.
Nice piece of hitting by Gavin.
And it was a nice piece of hitting. Yes, in the hole.
Yes. Didn't try to pull the pitch. Just went with
good point. Yes. Nice. We like to have fun up here, especially with the day I've had. FCC should be on alert, though.
Happy for you.
I'll just say it now. If I say anything I shouldn't, I apologize now.
Hit a damn.
Yeah. We have 46 viewers. That's awesome.
Good eye.
So two balls, one strike. Oh, and I forgot I have the scoreboard on the screen now. I got to change it.
Two balls?
I'm not sure. If I said that, I'll be honest with you. I don't know what the count is.
Maybe it is 2-1.
So Carson's at the plate. Takes a ball. Two balls, one strike, we believe. When the youngest person up here is 51 or 52 now, we're kind of in trouble. Oh, hey, remind me. I want to announce something here. And then Ball 03. Must be, you were right, Joe. Ken McMullen passed away. Yeah. I'm going to put a thing out. What's that?
So did Barb Geedy.
Oh, did Mrs. Geedy?
Yep.
I didn't know that. I'm going to put a thing out on Facebook later. Is he not 89? I think Robert said. Yeah, I didn't see it yet.
Yeah, my mother was a good friend.
There's a ground ball to shortstop. Could be two. Out at second. Oh, I'm watching it. They got him. Oh, my. I'm watching the play instead of moving the camera. I told you guys I got that first play, and now I'm in trouble. So I apologize, but that was a nice double play turned by the
first inning.
Trojans.
Four ball to Galeria. One run on two hits. They move to the top of the second inning. With a score, ball to Galeria one. Mount Union scoreless.
We're going to run our sponsors here on the screen, but I forget to do that sometimes. If you still would like to be a sponsor, we'll take your money. Just reach out to me at douglas.dyke@beasd.net, or you can call or text me at 814-280-0250. Use that to buy updated equipment. Also pay for playoffs if we don't get sponsors. Luckily, we usually do get additional sponsor money for playoff events. We hope to do that for softball and baseball. And that rolls around here in about 4 weeks. It'll be soon. So the Eagles lead 1-0 after one. Down at this varsity softball field, the Eagles lead 1-0 after one. So 1-0 for both Eagle teams. Again, anybody has any comments? Taylor, he should be working.
Leading off the top of the second inning. For the Mount Union Trojans.
I'm getting y'all that.
First baseman Levi.
I do appreciate people chiming in most of the time, keeping me on my toes. So who's this batter, bud?
Levi Hunsinger.
I got to open up the Mount Union stats. Foul ball. So Levi Hunsinger is a freshman, so that's your second freshman to bat, third one in the game already. He's batting 312. Mount Union reloads. They have a very...
It takes me a year or two, but they get right back to it.
Very storied baseball tradition. I think they're in the 20s, the number of district baseball titles. You know, I mean, it's like bald eagle wrestling.
What's happening?
I have no idea. Oh, I think that stupid pitch calm.
It's a catcher.
I tell you what, those Burns kids are nothing but trouble.
You still working?
I thank God Addison's finally a decent athlete. I tell them that all the time. No balls, one strike. Little low. We got Mike Kresovich behind the plate. We got Tom Major League Burger. That's what my wife calls him. They drive the county vans together. She's the JV and he's Major League. There's a ball to right field. Foul.
In the bullpen.
I think I went so far I got the thing here on the in the. Oh, and I'm still running the
like
sponsors. Whoops.
Foul ball. Yeah, foul ball. Would you like an update on the softball game?
Yeah.
Eagles one with one. Yeah. Eagles 1-0. So
sorry, I'm still running the sponsors. I'm telling you, I'm trying. So anyway. Sponsors are off the screen now. One ball, no balls, two strikes. Top of the second, Eagles lead 1-0. Foul ball.
And softball leads 1-0.
Yeah, I already told you.
Hey, I'm telling you what.
This guy's salary is getting sliced in half.
I'm the oldest one.
Yes, sir. Respect your elders. Yes, Joe's reminding us of 1-0 in softball, and I do appreciate that. There's another foul ball. This kid's going to start buying. These baseballs are like $6 a baseball. I think every kid should show up with a deposit. Ooh. Ooh, that looked good. Two balls, two strikes.
That's because we have the best vantage point here. That's what I always tell the umpires. As a coach and a manager, I've always had a much better look at the home plate from third base or first base side than they do.
Swing and a miss on a high one. Strikeout. Is that his second strikeout? I believe.
Weston's, yes.
Yep, two strikeouts for Weston. Now we'll listen to Joe, the next batter for Mount Union.
Left fielder, number 10, Bryce Danish.
All right, this is Bryce Danish. He's a senior, outstanding pitcher who's had some arm troubles. It's his second game back. They said he played yesterday. He went 1-for-3. So he's batting 133. He has an RBI. He had a double yesterday.
Seems to have a pretty good cut.
He's a good ball player.
Oh, yeah.
Kreiner reminds me back in my day, if you really want to know. No, he's a lot skinnier, a lot better looking, fast.
Could hit.
Has a great arm when it's healthy. One ball, one strike. Other than that, we're a lot alike.
Identical twins.
Yep. One ball, one strike. He's Arnold, and I'm Danny DeVito. Ooh.
Ooh, a little breaking point.
Oh, he did. He called that a strike. Yeah. One ball, two strikes.
And Danish gave him an eye. He accepted
it. Hey. That's another way you know he's a good ball player. He gives people credit when credit's due. One ball, two strikes. Ooh. That hit him. Oh, he has a protector on, though. Thank goodness. That got him right on the elbow. He definitely didn't want to do that.
Number three, Wyatt Kresmer.
Sorry, 1-2 count. So Wyatt Kresmer is batting. Where do I see? He's number three. He's a senior, batting 300. So Mount Union has a runner on first with one out. McLean doinks Danish. McLean comes to the plate. Foul ball.
Do they go up there swinging, don't they?
Yes, they do. So, one out, runner on first base. Oh, great. Now Brenda Struble's chiming in. This ought to be good. Swing and a miss, strike two. I was hoping the Mets were playing so she wouldn't be paying attention, but she's being nice. I better. She says, "Hi, Joe and Doug, great job. What did I tell you about drinking in the afternoon, Brenda? Stay off the sauce." No balls, two strikes. There's a fly ball to left field. Should be caught by Burns. He snags it for out number two. Joe will give you the next batter here in a second.
Pitcher number 28, Cody McLean.
So Cody McLean, what number is he, Joe? 28. He's batting 385 on the season. Two outs now. Runner still on first, Danish. McLean with the pitch. Swing and a miss. Eagles lead 1-0 here in the top of the second inning. The Burns connection. Kale with a leadoff single. Gavin Burns follows with a single. Kale gets on his horse and scores. Pop up in the air. Out of play.
See, normally I would have given that kid an error in left field. That ball was rising away.
Left field's tough here, too. If he doesn't have sunglasses on and stuff, he's going to regret it.
And it was going over his head, and he did everything he could to reach up and at least get a piece of it.
Yeah, whatever.
That's what happened.
You're acting like another Joe. You can justify anything.
That's what
ball high.
That's what happened.
One ball, two strikes, two outs. Top of the second inning.
Look at me. That's what happened.
Sure it is. One ball, two strikes. Runner on first. The pitch. Pop up. Out of play again.
Over here in the parking lot.
I think the kids chasing the foul balls are getting more work out than the kids that are in the ballgame.
I think they are. Second inning down there.
There's a bus backing up. Is it still 1-0, Joe?
Eagles still batting, yes.
So the
Eagles are batting. 1-0.
You got to remember that. That's Habovic and Steer down there. It could be the fifth inning for all we really know.
Right.
One ball, two strikes, two outs. Run off first. Wind up in the pitch. Ball two. Two balls, two strikes. Eagles lead 1-0. McLean comes to the set position. He's coming home. A little low. Counts now full, right? Yes, full count. Full count on the batter. We've got a runner on first, so he will take off once he knows the pitch has gone home. The payoff pitch. Pop up out of play.
Cody McLean. Cody McLean.
Cody McLean. Who's Cody McLean?
It's a guy batting.
Oh, okay. Ball four. Mount Union has two runners on again. They had two runners on in the first inning. Now they have two runners here in the second inning.
Leadoff hitter, shortstop. Jamon Rank. Or Jamon Rank, excuse me. Now running. Four catcher or pitcher McLean is number 25. George Bilger. Bilger.
We got a timeout here by Ryan Mack. Is this the leadoff hitter?
Yes.
So he's number 9. What did he do the first time up, Brian?
He flew out to first base, popped out
to first base. Okay. He'll throw one on the day. McNamara heard the game on the internet, so he wanted to make sure he got a walk out to the mound. They think I don't know what you're up to, but
I don't know how to scrape up the money.
We've had 111 views, 59 concurrent. That's awesome. Try to put the sponsors on again. This time, remember to take them off. All right, so how are you saying their last, for this young man's last name is Frank?
Rank.
For Rank.
Jamon Rank.
Rank. Oh, for one. Freshman, leadoff hitter. Weston McLean, senior right-hander on the hill for the Eagles. Foul ball. How many pitches have you thrown so far?
42.
That's a lot of pitches already.
That was actually the
43rd pitch in 2 innings. Got to get that average down. Runners on first and second, 2 outs, 1 strike on the leadoff hitter for the Trojans. Must have been up a little. 1 ball, 1 strike. McLean did pitch on Monday. Threw enough that he only needed 2 days rest. Or 1 day's rest. Today's only Wednesday, right?
It is Wednesday. Remember we moved this game up.
No, he threw Sunday. That messed me up. We played Sunday. We were off Monday and Tuesday. Sorry, buddy. Yep, so 1 ball, 2 strikes. That might have been the first ever regular season Sunday game.
Might have been.
I know it is in my 30 years, but we're at that point now that we might have to do that periodically. 1 ball, 2 strikes. Oh, baby! Where was that puppy?
Oh. Three zip.
3 zip down at the... We got to come up with a name.
Down at the gold field.
Down at the, what's it called?
It's the gold field. The outfield's gold. It's
not, yeah, the wheat field.
It hasn't come in green yet. It's gold.
Yeah, so it's 3-0 Eagles in softball. Foul ball, just great. Why did OBS disconnect?
Oh. Guy just hit us with a ball.
So we're back here. Sorry, you didn't miss much. This kid's battling. 2 balls, 2 strikes. Gee whiz. Now he's hit a second batter this inning and loaded the bases. And he's been up or even on both his bat. So,
second baseman, number 5, Kanan Atherton.
And one of their best ball players is coming to the plate. Atherton. I don't know why we got disconnected there for a little bit, everybody, but we're using a portable Wi-Fi, MiFi, whatever, so let's hope that doesn't make it a habit.
Now
Atherton's batting, right? Yes.
Yeah.
But he singled the first time up, right? Yes. Good stick here at the plate. Mount Union looking to maybe take the lead. That's ball outside. The Eagles need to get an out somewhere. Get out of this pickle. Ball in the air. Hopefully Perry sees it.
And he puts it away.
All right, so good job, Connor Perry.
For Mount Union.
Good job, Weston McLean.
No runs, no hits. No Eagle errors. There were two HBPs in that inning. And the Trojans stranded three.
Base runners here, let's go.
Moving to the bottom of the second inning. It is Bald Eagle area. One. And Mount Union scoreless.
Eagles lead 1-0 after 1.5. What's softball now? 4-0.
3 hits.
I assumed not that would be probably a quicker. Brandon comes back with a good one. Mets play tonight, and you guys need all the support you can get. Okay, war has been declared. I still can't follow the softball. I do not understand. And OBS is disconnected and it's reconnecting itself again. Hopefully, folks, it won't make a habit of doing that. But don't go anywhere if it happens. So I don't know if it's just intermittent.
Leading off the bottom of the second inning.
Maybe it's the sun that's messing. All right, let's get this.
Number 12. Designated hitter, Braden Dubs.
So Braden Dubs, he's a designated hitter today. As I mentioned earlier tonight, he has his confirmation. Those Catholics, they'll take anybody. That's always been my motto. They'll take now.
Boy, he's sporting a very nice haircut.
You know what? He got out yesterday during lunch in study hall for that, and I haven't even paid. I was so busy this morning, I didn't even get to comment. But he takes a strike. Ooh, he waited for that off-speed pitch, but couldn't connect. So, I grew up a Methodist. I take anybody, too, so I don't want to offend any Catholics. But great job. He's batting 538 in the year. Is he paying you, Mr. Burns? Because
he fixes them all after I mess them up.
Oh, is that what happens? He found out what the password is. Okay. No balls, two strikes on Braden Dubs. He hits a ball to right field. And it's caught about 5 feet from the fence. But yeah, he put a little. That went further than I thought it was going to. So one out for the Eagles. That brings up.
Catcher, number 24, Caden Burns.
Caden Burns is batting. How about you go to the Bald Eagle page, Dingy? 5:45 on the season. He puts a ball in play.
Get a good turn, Dorn. Get a good turn.
Kid has sunglasses on this inning, and he catches a can of corn. He hit a ball solid there. Just got under it a little bit.
Flag going anywhere.
Yeah, flag is completely. I don't know if you can see.
Hey, hit the ball hard here. Hit the ball hard. Line drive. Still.
First baseman, number 40, Wyatt Speckman.
So Wyatt's batting 500. He's 6-for-12 on the season.
Yeah. Hooked down the top.
One ball to Speckman. Eagles lead 1-0 here in the bottom of the second inning.
It's further in the center field.
There's a ball in play
by Speckman.
Right fielder goes over, makes a catch. That kid only threw how many pitches that inning? Probably about 6, 7?
5.
Yeah, we need a 5 inning out of West in this inning. Just because that'll help him out.
3-up and 3-down inning. We've completed 2. And it's Bald Eagle area 1. Mount Union scoreboard.
Hey, big wish.
We got down there, down in the eighth, or we 6-0 now. With only 3 hits. What inning?
Second.
Oh, thank God. I don't think Jamie went down to some of that.
For you, there's nothing in this world I can do.
Make a phone call here real quick.
Hey, brother, do you still believe in one another? Hey, sister, do you still believe in love? Oh, the sky comes falling down for you. There's nothing in this world.
Hey, did you go to the field? You're down at the JV practice field. All right, that's what I thought. They just asked if they needed a late bus. Thanks, I'll tell them now. Thanks, buddy. Bye.
For Mount Union, leading off the top of the third inning is number 33, the catcher Blaine Hunsinger.
All right, so Blaine Hunsinger comes to the plate for Mount Union. He had a base hit too, didn't he?
What?
Or not?
Big West, that Big West.
Way to get on top.
Can they go back-to-back hits?
Here we go.
Yes.
That pitch was a strike, sorry. 1-1, now that was a ball. Brian Burns doing my job and two of his. Keeping me
8-0
and four hits. The Eagles are rolling down at Eagle Softball Stadium.
Now it's the top of the third.
2-1. It's not 1-1. I'm trying to do too many things at once.
Sorry.
1-2.
Down there, it's the top of the third.
Top of the third. It's softball. 8-0.
It's
the
top of the third here. It's 8-0, and we have 4 hits.
Okay. Swing and a miss. McLean gets his 3rd strikeout.
Hey, good start there, Tony.
Center fielder, number 7, Landon Kreismer.
I can't remember what he did. I think our thing just dropped, but it's back live again.
Stacy said her game changer isn't working for down there either.
So I wonder if they're supposed to be using someone's hotspot. I wonder if she's not connected.
Wonder if somebody's not.
Because we have the MiFi up here. Foul ball.
Whenever you take your cuts, huh?
I don't even know who I could call down there. So is it 1-1?
Yes.
Come on, Wes. Come on, babe. Come on, babe.
Foul ball again.
Let's go.
1 second, everybody. Hey, can you run down to the dugout and see if Olivia Boone is actually on the internet? We can't see the game on Game Changer.
Come on, baby.
1-2. Foul ball again. I'm telling you what, folks, you get so much during these games that you don't get with professionals.
That's right.
You get phone calls, text messages.
You get involved.
Yes.
It's like participation.
You don't get a
it's
meal.
Like you're there.
Yeah. I've gotten 2 peanut butter eggs. If anybody knows. Ground ball. Base hit. Oh, and I didn't follow that. Sorry, guys. It was up the middle towards short. It was between short and second base. So right back the middle. My bad. Why don't you get him baseball, Doug? There's one out now, runner on first.
Third baseman, number 12, Dylan Schauber.
So that's Mount Union's 6th base runner. They had 2 in the first, 3 in the second, and now 1 in the 3rd inning. McLean pitching from the stretch, comes to the plate, ball high. So, Burnsy, since you know this team better than I do, who do you think is probably your relief guy?
Today?
I'm saying Tate.
I think Tate.
Tate. Probably, okay.
Yeah. Hey, big one. Come, baby. Turn out.
Nice clean. Carson would get his D1 offer so he could start pitching.
Foul ball. One ball, one strike.
Hey, make sure one.
One ball, one strike, one out. Runner on first. Man, they're just missing. What do you think of that one? Oh, you got one too. Good job, buddy. That was. Mike does a good job, so please don't take it and be criticized. But I like that one right there. But it must have just been a tad low. Ground ball.
Here we
clip,
Kale 1.
Oh, what a double play. What a double play. Holy smoke. What a hot dog. Put a little mustard on that next time, buddy. Now, what a great double play. Yoder to Burns to Spadman. Eagles get out of that inning with only one runner on base. Joe will give you the breakdown here in a second.
Fort Mountain Union. No runs, one hit. No runners left on base. And an Eagle double play. Moving to the bottom of the third inning. Ball to Galeria. 1. Mount Union scoreless.
Okay, so while I'm running the advertisers. Yeah, the sponsors again. Saturday, we're here at 1 o'clock, hopefully.
Yeah, we'll be here.
Joe, you're killing me.
I told you that. I gave you plenty of heads up.
Man, I forgot. So I'll be announcing and doing the streaming.
That's right, you'll be doing it all.
Brian will be doing the scoreboard and the scorebook. We'll have a keg of beer up here. No, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. Oh, shut up, Jim. Now, hey, I was wondering if Gary Heverly's around. I'll have to text him. See, he usually fills in for me when he can't be here. He's now big time, you know. Vocational school principal over in Mifflin County. So, yeah, I only see him when he tries to run me off the road in the development. Yeah. Nah. So. Oh, that's all right. So, now, hey, if nobody's harassing me, but then I'm worried. No, you didn't. No, seriously.
Fort Baltimore area. In the bottom of the third inning, right fielder number 1, Connor Perry.
All right, so let me. Good, thanks, bud. Connor Perry's batting. He's our sophomore right fielder, and he is batting on the year. Oh, hey, how about you go to Bald Eagle stats, Doug? 83. He's making contact. He just hasn't had the ball be able to drop in too much.
Are you seeing it?
Takes a called strike.
Come on, Connor Perry. Come on, kid.
Ball high. One ball, one strike on Connor Perry. Ball in play. A little fly to second base, and it's snagged, so one out.
We'll be here, Cam. Be lead off, go for one here
yes,
now.
The Eagles will play Du Bois in a makeup game on Monday, or Saturday at 1 o'clock.
Number 42, Cameron Watkins.
This is the one where I just never thought I'd see
top,
this.
Roll top, Cam, roll top.
What's his number?
42?
It's so unbelievable. It's not even on the stat sheet. Now I gotta go down. He's batting 769 on the season. He takes ball low.
So, let's go, baby.
Yeah, and don't forget, next Saturday, the Eagles play at 9 a.m.
at
next Saturday, the 20th, at 9 a.m. at Lebrano Field at Medler Field at Lebrano Park. There's a line drive by Watkins. Oh, and he snagged it. What a catch. That's a nice catch. Nice running catch by the left fielder. Hopefully I didn't miss it. Did I swing too far? Might have swung too far. Cameron tagged that one. I mean, he hit that nice shot.
Shortstop number two, Cale Burns.
So the game is at 9 o'clock on the 20th. You got to get your parking ahead of time online for Penn State for $5 or something. Because if you don't, everybody has to. Yes, Joe.
You're not going
to
take care of me.
No. They're not even taking care of me, Joe. Sorry. I think I'm a bigger time. No. But if you go up there that day, it's $40. Yeah. So you get a, I'll put the link on Facebook.
Come on,
one ball, one strike. But yeah, that's against Bellefonte. That would have been a regular season game, Bellefonte and Bald Eagle Green. And then the winners play it. Pop up. Hopefully out of play. Losers will play at 3 o'clock, winners at 6, and winners and losers of the DuBois Central Christian State College game at noon.
Go, Cale Burns!
DuBois Central Christian won single A last year, right?
Center.
I think so.
There's a line drive right to shortstop. It's bobbled. Yeah, I thought he got him too. Just got him. Yep, hit the ball hard 2 out of 3 times and hit the ball all 3 times, so can't really complain. So we're going to go to the top of the 4th inning.
Hey, throw a leather at him, boys, throw a leather at him, let's go!
No runs, no hits, no errors, nobody left on base for Baltimore area. We move to the top of the 4th inning. Still, Eagles 1, Trojans scoreless.
You got down there, Howard Cosell.
8 runs, 5 hits.
Softball's still up 8-0. Supposed to play at Bishop Carroll on Friday. That's going to be iffy because of the rain tomorrow and some Friday. Check. Best place to check for updates is Bald Eagle Area Athletics on Facebook. Or is it BEAathletics.org? Is the website, which they just changed the format. Right, that gets updated as soon as I make a change. So, how many pitches is McLean up to now, Scott?
64.
64 pitches, so he has 36 left.
Four Mountain Union, leading off the top of the 4th inning. We first baseman number 17, Levi Hunsinger.
So next week, I'm going to try to give you the schedule. Baseball's at home on Monday versus P.O.
I'm Big West.
We'll probably do that one because there's not softball that day. Ground ball. DeNagle. And is that an error on the first baseman? Spackman drops the throw from Nagel, so Mount Union has a leadoff runner, their 7th runner on base so far today.
Left fielder, number 10, Bryce Danish.
So I'm trying to follow the play. He got hit. Danish was hit by a pitch the last time. What happened there? Did it hit? Was it a bouncer at all, or just hit the glove and came out?
He went to like
scoop.
Like he scooped it, but then on like on the way up, the ball was rolled out of the mitt. Almost like the web was too wide.
Oh, okay.
We get on top. We get on top, baby.
So that's a called strike.
Come on now, Bryce.
So one strike on the batter. Danish. Like I said, I think he's going to Delaware to play baseball.
Yeah.
Ground ball. Gonna get two here.
There we go.
So the Eagles turned their 2nd double play of the day.
Hey, there you go, Spack. Got it, baby.
Hey, that's what good defense
does
for you. And if you're a pitcher, that should help you know I just got to throw strikes. My guys are going to help.
Real nice.
Right fielder number 3. Here, Wyatt Reismer.
What'd he do the first time up, bud?
He.
Do a little warm up now.
Hit by pitch? Yeah, hit by pitch.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh! No!
Nice.
So one ball, one strike. So Monday baseball's at home. Tuesday I know track and field's at home.
Oh. How the baby doing?
It just doesn't, I mean, you're not getting a low strike. Huh? 9-0?
5-5.
Go West, go West.
Bottom of the third.
So Tuesday the 16th, junior high baseball's at home. Fly ball. Coming in. Damn, comes in. And he took charge, and you definitely don't want to get in the way of that train coming through.
Let's go, let's go.
Yeah, they did. Right to the
line.
Oh, double play. My bad. My bad. I'll shut up, Joe. Go ahead, bud.
Let's go, fellas. Let's go.
Four man union. No runs, one hit. And there was one eagle error. End of double play in that inning. 1-0. Ball to Galeria.
So Tuesday's a home quad track again. Junior high baseball. Awesome. And then Wednesday the 17th, varsity softball is home at Penn's Rally. That'll be 5 on New York Baskers. Well, yeah, it'll be live for a little bit. Probably the whole time, but I can't be there the whole game, so.
Hard.
Maybe we'll sucker Joe into coming doing that game Wednesday, Joe. Any interest in doing this on Wednesday for a softball game? I have to go to the District 6 meeting, so I can be there for a little bit, but then I gotta leave. Okay, cool. Well, I'll get y'all set up and stuff. So we'll be on streaming, and hopefully Joe will be on. In the 18th, I have junior high baseball at home, junior high softball, so no varsity, no streaming on Thursday. 19 baseball will be home with Somerset and softball with Somerset. So since
left fielder,
that'll probably
number 26, Gavin Byrne.
That'll probably be softball that day. I'll have to check and see, but I want to make sure I get an equal amount of games on. So here we go, bottom of the fourth inning. Gavin Burns is up. He's 1-for-1 with an RBI single.
Come on, GB.
One ball. Eagles lead 1-0 here in the bottom of the fourth inning. Two balls on Gavin Burns.
Hit it hard. Hard on the line, baby. Let's go.
Gavin has the second highest batting average on the team. And he has the hit tonight, so. Ooh, got ahead of that one a little bit. It's a.
Turned on it.
Looks like one of my. Well. Looks like a right-handed hook on the golf swing or one of my hellacious slices. 9-0 down at the softball field.
Down at the complex.
What's this inning? Ball in play. Made a nice snag at third. Base hit. Now that was an infield single.
It's top of the fourth.
Top of the fourth, okay. So softball's up 9-0. They get one more run. Or however morning one or more runs and gets three outs, that game will be over. That brings up Tate and Yoder.
Number 9, Tate and Yoder.
So I should let Joe do that. Tate and Yoder, and he popped out his first time up. Tate's due. I think he's going to get a base hit right here. Runner. Of course, I'm blocked by the thing, so. Yeah, I
like perfect pitch.
So what was the pitch?
Yeah. Hey. You're all right.
One out. Now. One ball.
Ball take your.
Yeah, that might have been called by the coaches, but whew, just had a leadoff single.
Surprising. Hey, Gary can announce on Monday, same compensation as previous years. Yeah, we doubled it. Or yes, no, we doubled it. So one ball, one strike?
I can make it Monday. It's Saturday.
Yeah, I said Saturday. I'm sorry. I got too many days in my head.
You mean Saturday.
Yeah, Saturday at 1 o'clock, Gary Haverly will be.
Good eye.
Two balls, one strike. And you know what will happen here. He's going to get on.
He was high.
Because every time you get thrown out with less than two outs, usually the next guy up gets on.
You're all right.
There it is.
Yep. That's the baseball gods going, you should not mess with me.
They do that.
What are you trying to say?
Third baseman number 22, Carson Nagel.
I've been watching Major League so much, it just pops in my head at the overtime. You trying to say Jesus Christ can't hit a curveball?
All right, fellas, let's not start a holy war here.
Yeah, let's, okay, fellas, yeah. What's that stuff on your arm, Crisco?
K-Y.
Yeah. If they're really watching me, I put a little bit of jalapeno up my nose and wipe my nose. You put snot on the baseball?
Hey, we get to be
my one strike on third baseman Carson Nagel. One ball, one strike. How many pitches is this young whippersnapper up to?
37.
He's done a nice job. Gave up those first two hits, gave up a run.
First hit
they just got, Bellwood Ann's got their first hit. There's a shot by Nagel. To left field, Eagles. Again, hindsight's 20-20, but we should have the base loaded. Sorry.
Designated hitter, number 12, Braden Dubs.
So runners on first and second, one out. I just saw the umpire, Mike Kresovich, give Tom Berger the signal. Infield fly rule is in effect. Less than two outs, runners on first and second. Eagles one out was on a throw out. Nice throw to second base to get Gavin Burns, who led off with a single. Brings up Braden Dubs. What did Braden do the first time up?
Flew out to right field.
Oh, that's right. It was a liner. Solid contact, just right at the guy. One strike going Dubsy. There he hits a shot. It's going to be caught. Left fielder is playing a heck of a ball game after that tough start. Again, he hit it right on the nose. They're just hanging in the air. So the Eagles now have two outs, runners on first and second.
Brings number 24, the catcher, Caden Burns.
Caden Burns comes up. He lined out too to left field, if I remember.
Real deep.
Another solid shot. They're getting good swings. There's a ground ball down third base. Did he score him? All right, so Caden Burns has a ground ball single to right left field.
Did he get any gloves? 1-5.
He what?
Did he get any glove on that?
No.
Oh, that's a hit. Yeah, that was a hit. So Caden Burns gets an RBI single.
There's baseman number 40, Wyatt Speckman.
Speckman comes to the plate, and running is Nick Weibel.
Now, courtesy running. For Burns. Number 15, Nick Weibel. Weibel.
In the bottom of the fourth inning. Burns, he's doing his three different sore book things. Live stream the games, so you also are part of the broadcast team, even though you don't wear a headphone. Okay, so Brenda's still chiming in. So they had a little powwow on the mound. Who's batting? Wyatt's batting, right? Sorry, I'm trying to send a text to somebody. What was the pitch? Ball? Okay. So one ball on Wyatt Spackman.
We did?
Yeah, Eagles have a run in. Yeah, I was going to do that for you even, and I forgot to. So Eagles lead 2-0 now. Ball in play. That's going to be out of here. Spackman just did a 3-run homer. Left fielder disappeared over the fence. He looks like he's okay. He gets the ball. So Wyatt Spackman hits his first varsity home run. And now gets the Eagles a 5-0 lead.
Spackman.
Single to left.
Now batting right fielder. Number one, Connor.
What's that? Only scored one, yep. Guy on second scored.
Okay. And then
Weibel came in to pinch run.
Okay.
Which isn't a huge deal in a game.
So then how many pitches did he have?
Hey, starter down with two now. What do you say, man?
He had a ball.
He had a ball, yep.
And then he had a home run.
A 3-run home, right?
Back. Yep. So it's 5-0. I'll get this. Don't you worry about that. Whoa, whoa,
whoa. No home run?
There is one. Fly. You have to hit the fly ball one. There we
go. Kid.
So we got Connor back.
Hey, sir,
was there a pitch yet? Okay. Just, I'm doing this so he can get his books in order.
Good eye.
All one.
Looking yours.
I wasn't even trying to jinx the young man because he was doing a nice job except for the first inning. And now the Eagles lumber has started to put the sticks in.
Yeah, the inning before that they started.
I'll cut one.
Okay, you're caught up there.
Yep.
They've
been doing a nice job, meaning the Eagles are making contact. They just, like I said, the left fielder's made some really good catches. Right fielder has one.
Good eye.
I can keep doing that. You know?
As I'm looking at the Bart Simpson blue sky and clouds, good move, moving the game from tomorrow to today.
I can't, this kills me to say this, but it was actually first brought to my attention. Cale Burns had checked their schedule.
Let's go.
Nope, too much air.
Yeah. So, 4 runs in that. Right?
Yep.
2 hits.
We're holding Larry. 4 runs in the inning.
Go, Wes. There you go, baby. There you go.
There were 2 hits.
Good job.
There were no Mount Union errors.
Good job.
And at the end of 4 innings, Baldy Galeria, 5. Mount Union is scoreless.
I ain't going up here. Let's go.
Yeah, we gave him a hit.
Okay.
Yeah, it was an infield hit, and he got kicked off in second.
Number 28, pitcher Cody McLean.
It's the fifth inning, right?
Yes, top of the fifth, sorry folks, I'm trying to answer emails. The ball in play, the Cam in center. That's good, one pitch, one out. He's in the 70s now, right? The pitches?
71.
71.
Those are going right to the JV bucket.
For Mount Union, leadoff hitter.
Did I say Jamin?
Oh, what?
Number 9, shortstop, Jamin. Rank.
Come on, Wes. We didn't.
Low outside. The Eagles now lead 5-0. One out. Mount Union going their third time through the lineup. Ball in play.
Yeah.
I can't put a tag into that one. Face of the fence. Yeah, he did. He just missed it. He hits a double. So, Mount Union has a one-out double.
Second baseman, number 5, Kanan Atherton.
By their leadoff hitter. So top of 5, they get 3 outs off, all be over.
10-5, end of 4 innings.
Ball outside. Get on second, has a decent secondary lead. Got to keep an eye on him, even though I know he's not super important, but McLean comes to the belt. The pitch. It was a little high. 2 balls, no strikes. Oh, 3 balls. My bad.
Come on, West.
There's a ball in play. Carry with the catch. Coming in.
Hey, good hunt. Good hunt. Come on, another
man. If I got that. I was kind of watching, kind of moving the camera. So Connor Perry snagged that in right
field. Number 33. Runner moved out from second to third.
2 outs now. Mount Union has their second runner on third for the day. McLean can go from the windup now.
Come on, D. Make play.
Who's back?
Rosenberger.
Yeah, they do. And they like to swing at the first pitch.
Yes, they do. Well, with the pitch count, most pitchers try to get the first one up.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's turned into a different game.
Oh, my Lord.
What was that?
One ball.
West.
1 ball, 1 strike, 2 outs. Strike 2.
Come on, West.
I'm 1-3.
Hey! Third strike.
Hey!
Yep. So we're through 4.5 now. Easily 5-0.
For Mount Union. No runs, 1 hit, 1 runner left on base. We move to the middle of the 5th inning, the stretch inning of the 7th inning ball game. Ball to Galeria 5. Mount Union Trojans, scoreless.
Hey, how many baby can? 9-1, Tom Barrett.
Thank you.
can't begin to know it, but then I know it's growing strong.
I don't know what's going on with this softball game.
Wasn't the spring, and the spring became a summer. Who'd have believed you'd come along?
New pitcher, bud. Number 9. Freshman. Nope. Oh yeah, number 9, but I just said that's not the leadoff. Number 9.
Doing the pitching for Mount Union is number 9, Jamin Rank. Rank now doing the pitching for Mount Union.
He doesn't look phased. I mean, not he should.
Leading off the ball in the fifth inning for the Eagles, number 42, center fielder Cameron Watkins.
Cameron, what, lined out to center? Now, what did he line out?
Left field.
Batting over 700, and he smoked it, but kid made a nice little running catch.
Yeah, that third inning was very good. And fourth inning,
hey,
catch.
Come on, hey, Cam!
A little late on that one. Being aggressive. So one strike on Cam Watkins.
Good eye.
I just heard a cheer down there, Bill. Or Bill.
Go, Cam. Go, Cam.
Game over, maybe.
Yep. Play track.
Turn out the lights. The party's over.
Tough one. Hey, now go to bow. Lock in here. Lock
one ball, two strikes on Watkins.
One ball. Can't miss a ball.
I think so. I think there was a ball, wasn't there?
Yeah, well, I got it on here. Okay.
I'm not being critical. I want you to do four things. Oh, you are doing four things. I thought maybe that was going to be called strike three.
Go, Cam.
Two balls, two strikes.
See you all the way, baby. See you all the way. Go with it.
He just did not look solid there at all. Nice job by that young man.
What happened?
Call third strike. He buckled those knees, baby. So that brings up
leadoff hitter number 2, Cale Burns.
He needs a few.
Yeah.
What do you need?
Okay. Oh, actually,
did you get all the positions?
Actually,
yeah. Just give
him
to him,
and I'll get it.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Oh, come on, we got ice. Let's go.
Okay.
All right. So one ball. I can do this if you're. Yeah, see, I'll do this because I know you're in the middle of something. You're trying to do your Doug Dyke impersonation. I wanted. He's doing three things at once, Brian Burns.
He's at second.
So, Cale Burns has two balls.
All the way here.
Three.
More for it.
How about it? Hey,
it's
going
to pay off,
buddy.
I hope so.
What do you want?
I'm just kidding.
You know I'm just teasing you, honey.
No!
Yeah, that's fine. I don't know what was going on. I couldn't get on it. So,
who was the final 10?
If we play tomorrow, I can send that with you, but I need it back for Saturday's baseball game.
Okay.
So I'm not trying to be so.
No, it's okay.
We'll hook up with our numbers, so you're coming back. I mean, all you need to do is school and hand it around.
When? Friday or Saturday?
Friday. Like, are you going to the game at Bishop Carroll?
With
yeah. So, hold on a second. Ball in play to Burns, big hop. Goes over to first, just beats it out. So if we play Friday, I'll send
changes
that with
from
you.
Changes
for
Mount Union. Right now, they're into pitching. Kanan Efferton is now at third base.
All right, I'll just,
Dylan Jobber is now at shortstop.
Will you be there when we get back?
And into the game, number 27, at second base, is Layden Brown.
Okay. And if I can't meet you there, we'll
not
figure
the
out
batter.
Where you can put it.
Okay, perfect.
Fort Walton, Galeria.
That was Olivia Boone,
is
everybody.
Number 26,
she's
left fielder, Kevin Burns.
For the softball team. Hope so. We have one out now. Oh, wait. One out, right? No, two outs.
Two outs.
Now Gavin Burns is up. He's 2 for 2.
Ropes one down, the left field line foul. So that's a strike.
826, help me, babe.
I think right now the ball looks like a watermelon for him.
Hey, now you go to battle. Go to battle. Take control in there.
Yeah, he's throwing something that kind of has him perplexed a little.
Is he even bowling or no?
I didn't think so, but I was talking to Liv, so there might be.
Hey, why are you on yours here, Jimmy? What do you say, babe?
2-2. Put it down.
Come here, babe. Come on, Jimmy.
Sorry. Ball up to right field. So,
and that will do it.
Yeah, Eagles go three up, three down in the bottom of the fifth.
We have a hit.
Hold one down.
No, sir.
No hits.
Nope, three up, three down.
For the Eagles in the bottom of the fifth inning. Three up, three down. Moving to the sixth inning, Baltic Area 5. Mount Union scores.
Chesney, drop him down.
So the other day, they had the fastest baseball game in the major leagues since 1994. 2 hours and 1 minute.
Wow.
Yep. I can't remember which game it was, but I heard them talking about that on the Pat McAfee show. Did you ever watch that? Those guys are hilarious. Today they were talking about, you know how they have that TBT basketball tournament in the summer where they play for $1 million? They're doing one for soccer. And J.J. Watt is part owner of Burnley and the English soccer leagues. I don't know if they're the top division or whatever. So J.J. Watt.
Leading off top of the sixth inning for the Trojans. Number 7, center fielder, Landon Kreismeyer.
So, and Pat McAfee's putting the team in, so then they were talking smack about who's going to have the best. But just, they're funny. I mean, it's a whole bunch of guys talking sports for a living, making a pretty good living, but just have a blast. I'm so jealous. Strike one, sorry. There's a foul ball. So McLean, where's he at on pitches now, Mr. Burns?
83.
So, it's doable.
Oh, I think it has changed.
The ones that are crossed out.
Oops. Mistakenly gave him a one ball, one strike count when it was 0-2, so it was a called third strike, so that's one out for Mount Union.
Kershaw, number 12, Dylan Chubber.
Which ones are crossed out?
Foul ball. He went from.
So girls softball won 10-0 and 5 over Belladonna's. That runs their record, I think, to 4-1 on the season.
Right.
They lost their opening game to Tyrone. Boy, Tyrone came out just swinging the sticks. Ground ball to third, bobbled by Nagel. Picks up, throws the first.
Good job, Carson, that away. Hey, nice play. Please stay with it.
Didn't have it over quite far enough. But ground ball, out number 2.
First baseman, number 17, Levi Hunsinger.
Mount Union first baseman Levi Hunsinger comes to the plate.
Hunsinger, which one? Still catching. Okay.
He's a catcher.
Chris Kreisman is still in center field.
Called strike.
Dylan Schauber is now a shortstop. He was at third base.
Third base.
He's now at shortstop.
Okay.
Ground ball.
Nice play.
Oh. Nice try.
What are you giving
him? I give him a hit. That's an infield hit. Carson made a nice play, but couldn't get a good throw off because he was on his knees. So.
Left fielder, number 10, Bryce Danish.
What's McClain doing?
The runner on first, two outs.
Okay. Is Layden Brown.
Bryce Danish at the plate, playing center field.
It's L-A-H-D-E-N, Layden Brown.
Ball to ball.
And he's now at second base.
This one extra batter, hopefully, this could cost Weston to possibly get to finish the game. So one ball, one strike. Too hot to handle, too cold to hold. They call me Dougie Hussers.
Oh, that's a good spot. Great good spot.
Is it me or is that
how
are
you doing?
There's a hard ground ball. Oh, he called it out on the long line drive, so it didn't matter, but he went to the base just to make sure, but umpire Berger called him out on the line drive. Sorry.
Come on, Union, no runs, one hit.
There's a line drive to Cale Burns at shortstop. Sorry.
One man left on base. Looking to the bottom of the sixth inning. Holding area.
So how many pitches is he at?
Five. Mount Union, scoreless.
Yeah, I don't know if something's wrong with this microphone or not. Here myself.
92.
Here, so he's at 92. He's got 8 pitches. Why that is.
Fort Paul Galeria, leading off the bottom of the sixth inning, is number 9, Peyton Yoder.
So, Eagles second baseman Peyton Yoder comes to the plate.
Hey, free and easy here, baby. Free and easy.
What did he do the last time?
Long time.
Yoder?
Walked.
Walked, okay. So he's been on base one time.
Yeah.
Takes a cold straight.
It's just DH'ing now.
Okay.
Ross Collins is in his position in center field. Number 21.
Come on, Tate and Yoder. Come on, Tate and Yoder.
One ball, one strike on Tate and Yoder.
And the center fielder, Landon Christmer, to the right.
Ball two.
Yeah, he's in right.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. So, Toter. Tate and Yoder has a 2-1 count
cut,
on.
Love cut.
I'm getting harassed from Bellwood right now. Ball in play. Base hit up the middle. Yoder gets a base hit. That's what he's been looking for. Maybe that'll get him back on this. Right back the middle. Hard ground ball.
Ground ball or a
third baseman number 22, Carson Nagel.
Brings up third baseman Carson Nagel.
Hey, make sure of one.
Excuse me. Nagel takes a called strike, so Eagles have their leadoff hitter on here in the bottom of the sixth inning. Foul ball.
Changes for Mount Union. Wyatt Christopher is now in left field. Bryce Daney has moved to the designated hitter position.
Stay in control in there.
And Landon Prismer is now in right field for Mount Union.
Don't get the Collins kids in center field.
Oh, I'll get him.
Yeah.
Get on, head away, head away.
Also into the game for Mount Union.
Stay short and
quick. Now playing left field is number 21, Nas Collins.
In center field.
In center field.
Sorry, Joe. One ball, two strikes on Carson Nagel. He hits one straight up the chute to the third baseman.
Bob Prince was hit a home run in elevator.
Yeah, there you go. I was trying to think. You know he's 90 now? You say Euchre, right? Or no?
No.
Bob Prince. I'm sorry. Well, Euchre's 90 now, just doing home games.
Designated hitter number 12, Braden Dubs.
You can't say that on the radio. Ah, hell, there's nobody listening. Now batting designated hitter Braden Dubs.
No, not you.
All right, that, I'll tell you what. Hasn't been coming all that day, but Braden Dubs comes up, who might be related to him, and calls him a strike. That's ridiculous. I just kidding, having fun here.
That's
one ball, one strike on the junior designated hitter, Braden Dubs.
Jordan quick. Come on, Braden.
Dubsy puts a charge into that one. Collins seems to have it cornered. Hit it to dead center field. He did give it a ride.
Good job.
Nothing like a can of corn.
Good job, B.
The catcher, number 24, Caden Burns.
Burns had a hit the last time up.
Long drive, baby. Let's go.
Runner on first, Tayton Yoder, let off with a single. I was going to say, I thought I saw that, but I wasn't sure, so.
There he is,
boy. Yoder's now balked to second base. So, a base hit here could be another RBI for Burns. There's a ball in play. It might be in the gap. No, it's going to hang up. Yep.
Chez!
So the Eagles go down here in the bottom of the sixth inning. We're going to go to the top of the seventh. Eagles lead 5-0.
Come on, hustle out here.
Never. One hit.
Four ball to Galeria. No runs, one hit. There were no Mount Union errors. There's one runner left on base. Bottom of the sixth inning. Ball to Galeria, 5. Mount Union, 0.
Baseball got a win today in their first game at Altoona. It says Drew Nagel pitched 4 2/3. Weidsteimer got the last out for the save. The base is loaded. Isaac Johnson had a double and a triple with 3 RBIs. Looks like the final was 6-4. They were playing in Altoona. They played 5 inning double
headers. Left fielder, number 3, Wyatt.
All right, here we go. Top of the seventh inning. McLean has 8 pitches left.
Where are we in the seventh now?
Oh, yeah, sorry. Foul ball. So, top of the seventh, we got 1 strike on the batter. I got to pay attention here. Swing! And a miss. Strike two. Forget about the curveball, Weston. Give him the heater. He did. Just missed. One ball, two strikes. One ball, two strikes. Leadoff hitter here in the top of the seventh inning for the Mount Union Trojans. Called strike three. Yeah, 98.
I have 95, but
again, we might have missed a couple here, so.
Second baseman number 27, Layden Brown.
I like that the coach here has made some subs, getting some kids some, you know, good innings against a good pitcher. Ball in play.
Who was she stopping? Oh,
Chris. That was a foul ball.
You did that.
Yeah, we did.
Swing, he's gonna miss. Oh, sorry.
Well, maybe
no, we're fine.
Did he swing with that or no?
Yes. One ball, two strikes. Swing! And a miss. Two way. And whatever he's at, he can finish this batter, so.
Yes.
Or maybe not. Maybe not. Max coming out, maybe.
I'm at 99, so I might have missed a pitch.
How do you pronounce this kid's name, Jamie?
That's what.
And he was pitching, right?
Yeah, he's pitching, right, yeah.
Batter's number 9, Jamin Rank.
Yeah, so Tatum must be coming in because Tegan Runkle's going to right field, Joe. And Perry's going to come in to second, right? Isn't that what they do?
Yeah.
JT.
Hey, give that spot.
Yeah, so Tegan Runkle's going to have to finish this game because of the pitch count. Right now he's trying to do his best as David Bednar routine. No, I'm just kidding. Let's don't talk about David Bednar. Relief pitcher for the Pirates.
So who's in the second place?
Perry's coming in second. Perry. It was right field.
Perry
will be second. Yeah, Runkle's going into right field. Yeah, he'll be under the McLean spot. So again, reminder, our next streaming action will be Saturday at 1 o'clock. It'll be baseball again. And then next week we'll have softball.
Into the game for Baltimore area.
On.
Now playing right field. It's number 8, Tegan Runkle.
So a baseball Saturday, baseball
he'll be
Monday.
A playing spot. Now doing the pitching for Baltimore area. Moving from second base to pitching mound is number 9, Tegan Yoder.
So we'll have
and moving from right field to second base. Is number 1 Connor Perry. Perry for Boulder Galeria.
So we'll have baseball Saturday at 1, baseball Monday at 4:30, and then Wednesday, Joe will be doing softball at 4:30 against, I think it's Penns Valley.
Remind me before I leave here.
Okay, and he'll be down there with Steve Steer and Mike Kapovic. So first pitch for Yoder's a ball. Ball 2. Yoder probably hasn't pitched in a while, but I want to see him just throw strikes. He's hitting the same spot every time.
Just happens to be rolling.
Yep, just low. What
time is it softball?
4:30. So he walks him on 4 pitches. Mount Union.
Third baseman number 5. Kanan Atherton.
Or one runner on, I'm sorry, 2 outs.
Mm-hmm.
in twice.
Ready, Rook?
Monks, be ready.
Yoder just needs to keep a little eye on the kid at first, but just worry about getting strikes. I thought he might have got one there, but umpire Cressy Bitch didn't call it, see it that way, and he's the one that matters. One ball. Gets a called strike there. One ball, one strike. Tayton Yoder in to get the... I guess it wouldn't be a save, though, would it?
No.
No, not with 5-0 lead.
No.
Two balls, one strike. That one was a 58.5-foot curveball.
Chip. Oh, wait here now. What do you say, baby?
One ball, or two balls, one strike.
We're talking about the 17th, correct?
Sounds right. Little ground ball to Burns. He's going to flip it to second, preparing for the third out. Eagles complete the shutout victory.
They
run their record to 4-0.
Area, 5. Mount Union, 0.
5-0. Wait.
And what are the Eagles here again?
5-0. All right, so next week, they're here. They're at Bishop Carroll on Friday.
Carroll Friday.
Saturday, they're here at 1 o'clock. Monday,
here Saturday.
1 o'clock. And then here Monday at 4:30 versus PO.
Who do they play Saturday?
Du Bois. Friday, they're at Bishop Carroll.
For Baltimore area,
5-0.
Our Eagles will be at Bishop Carroll on Friday evening for a varsity matchup. They will be here on Saturday, right here at Baltimore area, Doc Enders Memorial Field, Saturday at 1 p.m. versus Du Bois.
Given the upcoming schedule.
And here on Monday,
thank you for joining
the
Mounties this afternoon. Of
Phillipsburg.
I didn't do too bad of a job, but
thank you for attending today's game.
Saturday at 1 o'clock, we'll be back in action here at
Doc Enders. We wish you a very safe journey home, and we hope to see you again in the future. We hope you enjoy today's game. Till next time,
we'll host the Beavers of Du Bois.
Good afternoon.
Have a great rest of your evening.